So before discussing the second FDP, I would like to use the presence of my colleague, Professor Sridhar Iyer. You recall in the last session I mentioned that he is now head of our ET activities. And so Professor Iyer, can you just come up? I have requested him for a specific purpose. You remember there was a question that participants in this FDP, participants in this workshop itself, and the other participants might want to participate in research activities, not just taking best practices to the students, but to enhance the research. So I requested him to share the research activities that he leads at IIT Bombay, he has been leading for past several years. All yours, Sridhar.
Okay, so many of you may have, we may have met in one of the conferences, right? How many people have attended T4E? Very good. How many people have attended ICCE also? Excellent. Okay, how many people have seen me in one of the FDPs over video? Okay, so everybody knows who I am, okay? So I am Sridhar Iyer. And I have recently taken over as the head of this education technology department. So since many of you have queries about how to do research and how to proceed with research in this area, so I thought I'll just spend some 5 to 10 minutes telling you about how we can do that. So this is a departmental web page. So if you go to, if you just simply Google education technology IIT Bombay, it'll take you there. And if you look at projects, so these two projects that we are seeing here, you know, technology enhanced learning of thinking skills and teacher use of education technology, these are the two big projects that we are currently focusing as the themes. So the teacher use of education technology is what you're already familiar with. So what we are doing in that is conducting FDPs like this, conducting the MOOC like 601TX, right? And so that the 601TX MOOC is basically to get an introduction to how to use education technology in the classroom, right? So subsequent to that, now each of you will have some good idea, okay, which you are going to try in your class, right? Every instructor has. Every instructor knows that, okay, I have this problem in my class, this is very specific to my students, and here is my idea that I am going to do to improve the situation. Okay, whatever may be the situation, whether it is the learning of students, whether it is making it more meaningful, whether it is you know, getting them more engaged, whatever may be the situation, each of you will have some idea like that, right? So in 601TX, what we saw was how we can use education technology effectively. You know, how to do active learning, how to use visualizations effectively, how to create flipped classrooms, all of that we saw in 601TX. So after that, after you have come up with some idea, what you can do is you can actually conduct some research about that topic, right? Whatever is your idea. So typically what we do as instructors is that we are just looking at the faces of our students, right? So I'm also looking now, okay, who's paying attention, who's playing with their phone, you know, who's talking to somebody else. So that gives me feedback on whether I am being effective or not. Okay, so that's one way of getting feedback. Okay, so many of us think that, oh, if I look at the class, I know whether they are understanding, I know whether it's happening or not happening. So that is a very ad hoc way of getting feedback on whether it is effective or not. So what we can do under this project, or what we call as teacher use of education technology, is to look at how to do it systematically. Okay, so earlier we had run a course. So this was a workshop which we ran in 2013. So this has the methodology for how to do the work systematically. So since it is available online, we may even repeat this as part of one of the, you know, 601TX or 602TX type of workshop. But most of the content is already there. So what we had done is in 2013, we had given a course on how to, yeah. So if you look at this page, how many of you have attended this course? Okay, there are a few of you who are familiar with this course also. Okay, good. So if you look at this page, this actually talks about how to take your idea and do some research around that so that you can not only get effective evidence for yourself, but also evidence to be able to convince others and also be able to write a paper. So when we did this, so what we had done was, again, we started in the same way. We gave one broad idea of how to use education technology. And then if you see the contents of this course, you know, so there are topics like, you know, what data to collect. There are topics like how to plan your study, topics like what is a research paper, how to know whether it's a strong paper or a weak paper, and so on, right? So going through this material will actually help you to plan your study. So there are templates which again are available from the education technology resources library. So if you go to our resources library, you will find evaluation resources which you can use. So there are lesson design templates, then there are research resources. Okay. And then what we do is, we had done a similar small scale workshop for some of the students, some of the teachers, to actually write the papers. So for those of you who are interested, what you can do is, you can take your idea. So I'm now summarizing what you can do. You can take your idea, you can look at the courses, the videos of this course, okay, which is called RMET, and there are templates which are available on the project website. So there are resources which are there on the project website, okay, which will actually help you to plan the study. So we have done this in a small scale. So in 2013, for example, what happened was, after we did this on a large scale, I think that time we had 1,200 participants or so, of which about 400 people said, okay, we want to continue. Okay, 10 of them actually finally went all the way to writing a paper and getting their paper accepted in T4E. So that is the process that you can follow. Okay, so after doing the FDP, take your idea, look at these resources. There are very systematic templates that are there. You just need to follow those templates, which will actually help you to construct your study. And once your study is constructed, then we can also interact. So that we do provide some kind of mentoring. So our TAs are available. So we can provide mentoring through this website. How many of you have a paper in T4E, had a paper in T4E? Okay, one. Okay. So maybe those people are not here, then otherwise it would have been more interesting to let them speak rather than me speak. Anyway, so we also provide mentoring for you to be able to construct a study out of it. Okay, so this is about teacher use of education technology. This is one way in which you can proceed with your own research. Okay, now what happens in this direction, if you want to go, is that many of these ideas are already well known. Okay, it's very unlikely that we would have come up with a revolutionary new idea which can go all the way to a PhD. Okay, so what we are doing is systematic research. So it goes to the extent of being able to help you take your idea, implement it properly, evaluate it properly, and publish a paper. So that is the scope of doing work in this area called teacher use of education technology. Now, if you want to think of doing a PhD itself, what we have is a different project. Okay, that's called technology enhanced learning of thinking skills. So here what we talk about is, so we have projects like, let me show a simpler one. Okay, so let's say knowledge integration. So each of us has certain thinking skills that can be developed well in our own courses, right? So for example, when I teach networking, one of the skills that I try to develop in my students is the skill of doing a pros and cons analysis. Okay, is the skill of doing design, how to do design. So each of you in your own courses, so if you're doing data structures, for example, you might want to talk about the skill of convergent thinking, how to get students to think so that they can analyze and make choices effectively. Okay. You might have skills like estimation, how to teach estimation. So in each course, so depending upon your discipline and depending upon the course, estimation might take different forms. But on the other hand, there are certain basic principles of estimation that we use, everybody is using. Okay? So this project is of that type. So where we identify different courses in which that thinking skill manifests, and then build systems for developing those skills in students. Okay, so these are some of the systems which are already developed. So this is a system for developing the skill of knowledge integration, how to take new knowledge and integrate it with your existing knowledge. So this system is on uses data structures and second year computer science graduates. So you could do a similar thing for your domain, for your course. Okay, so that would actually constitute original research towards a PhD. Does that make sense, what I'm saying? Okay. So that's basically it. So to go back, there are two streams of work. One is the teacher use of education technology. You can take your idea of what you're doing in the classroom, what you're doing in your own online environment, in your own Moodle environment, etc. Do a systematic study, do an evaluation, and it can culminate in a paper that you submit to T4E. Okay. So if some of you are already doing that, now is a good time to start talking to us, because the T4E deadline will come up in, I think, 2-3 months. Okay. So the next T4E is in IIT Madras. So now is a good time to get started with that. If you don't simply want to restrict to your own course and evaluation of your own teaching, what you can do is you can choose this idea of thinking skills. You can say that, okay, in my course, I can use my course to develop XYZ thinking skills in my students, and then we can go into theory of, you know, how you will develop that skill, how you will build a system for development of that skill, and so on. And that is a full-fledged PhD track. I mean, that will take a longer time. So this one is about 6 months to a year's project. The other one will be about 3 years, 3 to 4 years type of a project. So these are the two main ways in which you can participate.
So one question on their behalf is that while many of them here would be interested in taking this further because they have already taken the first steps, but I am looking at a larger canvas, that when these FDPs are conducted and when many of these people will act as our associate faculty members, number one, while conducting these FDPs, when they interact with people, if they find there are some people who are interested in pursuing research, then in addition to that FDP, how could they interact with them, promoting such ideas and suggesting mechanisms? That is one. Second, if and when the community grows larger, what could be the mechanisms of collaborating between themselves and with people in IIT, and in which way the ET activity under your leadership can facilitate that?
Okay. So the question is, how can we keep building on what we have done? So one way is that we already have a community development website. So JK, when he comes, is JK here already?
Yeah, he's coming.
He's coming, okay. So JK has done the work for setting up that portal through which all this community development program happens. In fact, when we did this meet workshop, what we actually did was there were some teachers in one college and some teachers in another college, both working on the same idea in their different courses, in their different colleges. And they together wrote a paper for T4E. Okay, so when we are doing, like, for example, if you say that, okay, I am going to do visualizations with ThinkPairShare in my class. Okay, now many of you may be wanting to do similar things, except that they will be in different courses. So what you can do is you can combine it all together and write one solid paper on that, saying that, okay, if we do it in electrical engineering, these are the results that we see. If we do it in, you know, some other computer science, these are the results that we see. So we have small evidence of that being successful. So now what we are doing is we are creating this portal. So when he comes, I'll let him talk about it. I don't want to steal this thing. So through that portal, we can not only connect people to others who want to do work on similar ideas, we can also encourage people to say that, look, if you are both are working on similar things, then you can collaborate together and thereby improve it. See, another advantage of this collaboration is that often there is some resistance from the management, right? Like when you are using some active learning technique, there is going to be some noise in the class. And many of you have asked me this question that, oh, how do I control that noise? What happens if my principal comes and says my class is too noisy and questions like that, right? So the more evidence that is there from the students that these active learning techniques are working, the more it's easier to convince others to also adopt these techniques. Right? For example, here, I think we started about 10 years ago implementing such techniques in IIT Bombay. At that time, there were very few of us. And we were kind of the outliers, and people used to say, "Hey, what is happening in your class? Why you're not lecturing? What are you getting paid for when students are doing all the work?" Right? So questions like that used to come. But today, but what happened is, the students wrote in their course evaluation that every instructor should start using techniques like think, pair, share, and so on. So today it's a fairly standard technique in IIT. Lot of people are using it. Flipped classroom has again become fairly standard. It's no longer something which one professor is doing, trying it out, you know, and trying to get away with not doing his teaching. No, all those ideas have now gone off. So the same thing can happen in all colleges when we generate a lot of such evidence that these techniques work. Yeah.
I remember during conference, we had a session of Pogel. Over there, I think the instructor had one option of controlling the crowd after TPS. Like, he used to raise the hand and everybody has to raise the hand and keep going.
Right.
So that I started doing in my class and it's working.
Okay, very good. Yeah, so all of us will have some technique of our own, right? So how to get back class control. Okay, we'll take a few questions. Is that okay? Okay, yeah. So.
Good afternoon, sir. My name is Dr. Jagpal. I attended ET 480 followed by MEET 2K15, both the programs. I've been implementing all these strategies and active learning strategies like TPS, PIE, other thing. But still, I don't find management is helping me out in that way. How to convince them?
You invite students to your college.
Nobody has come from my college. I invited them to be a part of this particular conference.
Right, so that's what I said.
My students, they agree, and they fully agree with the system I used to take. And they, in fact, have very much appreciated for that. At the same time, the management is just not agreeing. It's a small setup. There might be some issues with the resources, with other things. I won't say that. But this is the case. This is the case in happening real life.
Yeah, yeah. So there are two ways to attack this problem. Okay, one way is bottom up, where we collect a lot of evidence from a lot of teachers like you, saying that I tried it in my class, here is feedback from my students showing that it's work, it's working. So that's the bottom-up effort. And the other way is the top-down effort, which will happen tomorrow. So when AICT chairman comes, so we will talk to them also and say that, look, every college, every course must have at least one active learning activity in every class. It's not a very easy thing to enforce, but that is the top-down approach which we can try. So together, none of this is going to happen in, you know, 2 years or 3 years. So these are all, any education project which you pick up, if you want to make any change which is visible, it takes about 10 years. Even this project of ours, which we started in 2002, right? Yeah, 2002 is when we started talking about doing distance education. Today we have significant impact. So it has taken us 15 years to get here. So any of these changes is going to take time, but we'll have to just keep working on it.
Yeah. Good afternoon, sir. Myself, Julius, from Tyagarajar College of Engineering, Tamil Nadu, Madurai. Actually, past 2 years, I was on 3 years experience faculty. Past 2 years, I am following active learning session to my first year students. Actually, I am handling electrical machines for mechatronics. Initially, I just create a group of people by using a North Carolina State University. There is a link over that. By using that link, you can able to separate our students of learning styles they are having.
Mm-hmm.
At first, I have to separate all the three segregations. One is audio-visual learners,
okay.
Visual learners, audio learners, and practical learners. First, I segregate and I will make it as three groups. And from the three groups, I randomly pick up students. Since it is a first batch for me, I don't have that idea, so I randomly pick up and I just make three groups. And what I did is, after that, I just make a WhatsApp group to that particular class itself. I just understand what is their point of thinking, how they are doing activities within that group itself. That is passively I am there, and I just make a note of that. At the end of every assessment one, that is in our college level, they are having three assessments. Before that assessment, I just make this active learning for their refreshment. What are all we thought in that time, we will make them to enrich that knowledge through this active learning. What I am practicing is that by using my ME students as a volunteer, I just make a control over my students. How I am going to control that? I already separate all the three students and I just give five set of instructions over that. First team will have to prepare quiz, second one will be on circuit designing, and third one will be demo, and fourth one will be their own games. Because in WhatsApp they are very much interested in hangmans. Because everyone who is having BlackBerry or some iPhones, they are playing hangman games. I just make that hangman game into my academic. What I did is I just make, for example, magnetic sensor. I just make that into simple things, and I want other batches to explain what do you mean by magnetic sensor, what is the application of. And last one will be a connection, which you already know, day-to-day life things are getting connected to some academic things. That is an in Star Vijay, they are having one program like a connection in Sunday 1 o'clock.
Okay.
That thing is implemented there. So that what I did is from that, my impact will be most of the students are getting knowledge from other activities within that classroom. They can able to share their knowledge.
Okay.
Because that does not happen in day-to-day life in classroom.
Okay.
So this kind of activities every semester I did three, and at the end of time my response will be more and students' activities will be high. Even though they are not scoring any S grades or A grade or B grade, at the end of their final year they can able to know what do you mean by electrical machines, how that electrical machine principle is working, how they are relate that technique with their day-to-day life.
Okay.
This I am doing with the help of ME students. I am handling and managing for past 2 years. It is good.
So do you have a question?
No. Okay. If you ask that, my only one question is, if we are doing these kinds of things, we talk about think, pair, share, flipped classroom, everything, why not we can able to introduce some day-to-day life or their games or their point of view ideas into our learning techniques?
Yeah, we can. So I would like to respond to this idea. How many of you have similar ideas or some such ideas that you are trying in your own class? Okay, there's a whole number of people are there. Okay, that is exactly the point that I was illustrating. Each of us has such ideas. So what you have described is one idea, your idea that you are doing in your class. So what I just told about these resources is how to take, let me just spend one more minute on this now that. So these are the resources that we are talking about, how to do research. So exactly this idea. Now right now, there is really no way I'm not going to accept that your idea is a good idea. Okay, you're saying it's a good idea, fine, I heard you out, but that's about it. I'm going to say theek hai, okay, I'm not going to really accept that it's a good idea unless you prove it to me in some way. Okay, so the question is, how are you going to do that proof? So these are the resources that you can use for doing the proof. Okay, so you can start with looking at the research guidelines, how to conduct a research study out of this. Okay, you can look at the T4E 2013 tutorial slides. And then how to plan your study, how to write the paper. So those are all the resources that you can use. So each person who raised your hand saying that, yes, I also have an idea like that which I am trying in my class, if you use these resources, you will be in a position to submit a paper for T4E 2017. Okay. And we will be very happy to have large number of such submissions. So there was a question about community building. And I just mentioned that you will talk about the site. Why don't you just tell it now, since the question is...
So a quick question. How many of you had participated in ET601TX that was released last year? It was a MOOC course. How many of these top performers were part of the ET601TX? Just raise your hands. Background mein dikh nahi raha. Okay, so there is like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is a blog site, this is a WordPress blog site. So all of you know WordPress, right? So this is a WordPress blog site that we have. Look at the title, it is a pedagogy for engaging audience in reflection and learning through site blogs, Pearls. So we have a folder in this called ET601TX, which we are using for community building. So we encourage participants to be collaborative editors for this blog page, where you can actually write out what you have tried, you can upload resources of what you did, and possibly have someone comment on this. So typically any post, you have options for comments below, right? So you can use this comment features. You can, we can build a community around this, for example. So this is one particular platform, the WordPress blogs. How many of you were part of the earlier ET4ET program? Yeah, so there is, how many of you use Facebook? Okay, so this is our ET4ET Facebook page. So you can basically see the posts. So we had conducted a QIP program, quality improvement program, in 2013. From there onwards, most of the ET4ET efforts have been uploaded, has been broadcasted through this particular page. So facebook.com/ETQIP2013 is this page. So we'll be using it extensively for all the teacher use of educational technology, publicity. People can like our page, you can post your questions, there will be dedicated interactions over here. So these two are two possible community building exercises that we can immediately think of. And with respect to the FDP, so sir currently told you about how you can do evaluation within your own practice. So there, you can also explore evaluations within FDP also. So FDP is a large community effort. You are also doing some sort of community building within this exercise. And there are evaluations that IIT Bombay is interested with regards to implementation of FDP. So you can take a teaching learning problem within FDP itself. So for example, how engaged are the participants of FDP in discussion forum? Are participants who are engaged in discussion forum finally getting certificates? Are they continuing the practices beyond the FDP in their own classrooms? These are all valid questions which we don't know answers. So yes, some of you, so for example, the people who have participated in ET601TX, they have put their feedbacks in a Padlet. So how many of you know Padlet? So Padlet is another open tool for collaboration. You can post sticky notes in this. So you have a lot of, so the community Padlets are lesson plans created by the instructors who participated in ET601TX. And there is also a feedback. About what is happening after taking ET601TX. So somebody has noted that they use the contents of the workshop to run an internal FDP within their own college. So you can go through these experiences that these people are sharing. So currently all these are in staggered positions. People are posting it at some places. But by use of these dedicated mechanisms like Facebook and WordPress, we want to actually engage all of you in the community building exercises. So step number one, go to your Facebook page, like ETQIP 2013, start posting in that page, start posting relevant posts. Otherwise, the moderator will delete your welcomes, good mornings, etc., etc. Relevant to teaching learning. So all the posts needs to be relevant to teaching learning. Second thing, if you are interested in the ET601TX community blogs, please do contact us. Our email ID is tweet.
Okay, so while he's bringing up the email ID, let's just do one simple action item. I mean, he has shown you a lot of things that we have been doing over a period of time. So this stands for Teacher Use of Education Technology, TUET, okay, .iitb@gmail.com. Okay, so one immediate goal that we can take, since a lot of hands went up when I asked, do you have an idea, similar idea, which you are implementing in your class, what we can do immediately, JK, is that we can set up a site where they can post their ideas. These ideas that you're talking about, the idea like you said and somebody else said and all, you can post your ideas. JK will also post a list of questions that are of interest to us, like the ones that he mentioned, of how many discussion forum participants, what are they doing, and so on. And those of you who are interested can pick up either our ideas or you can progress on your own ideas. And through that forum, we will provide the mentoring so that you are in a position to submit a paper for T4E 2017. Okay. The deadline will be in July. So this is actually the best time to get started, because you have April, May, June, 3 full months to do the work and 1 month to write about it. How many people are interested in taking a shot for T4E 2017? Okay, so JK, dekh lo ek. Ek bar dekh lo. So this is the number of people that we have to kind of provide the mentoring for. That is fine, that's at our end, we will be able to do that. We have other people other than JK who will also be involved in this mentoring exercise. But at least if 50% of you wind up submitting, that will be great. Okay, I mean, lot of people start. Some people slowly, their enthusiasm goes down. Today everybody is excited. Okay, how many people are able to sustain the excitement till July? That's the question. But we will be there with you if you are sustaining the enthusiasm. Okay.
I would just like to mention one more thing. As you know, Professor Sridhar Iyer has been working with me ever since we started distance education, and today, after 15 years, we have reached this stage. And like many of us, he is very passionate about using technology in education. But he took a very important step internally. You remember we are talking about department and department responsibilities, and if I want to do this, and if my department may say so something. Last year he requested for a temporary change of department. So he has actually ditched computer science engineering department. And he is currently officially on a 3-year lien to educational technology department. Now, whatever he does has suddenly become his official duty. Earlier, it was only part of his secondary passion. It's a major change. So thank you, Professor Iyer. Let's give him a big hand. Incidentally, we are contemplating setting up a center of excellence in IIT for educational technology, particularly emphasizing online and blended education and large-scale outreach. Currently, as I said, there is some funding coming from the government, some funding comes from CSR, but this has to be a very large-scale sustainable activity. As I said, touching lives of at least 1 crore teachers and whatever, 35, 50 crore learners. And moving towards that, we need leadership both within IIT and at each of these places. What I want to tell you is that I expect Sridhar Iyer to lead that activity over the next 5-10 years in IIT Bombay. So thank you very much.